have COOH2. This is cyclobutane carbaxamide, because it's an amide functional group. Carbaxamide. Then if you have something of this nature, another likely functional group you might come across, this is cyclopropane what? Carbonyl chloride. You know, these are alkanoid chloride. If it is bromine, carbonyl bromide, and so on and so forth. If you have something of this nature, you have COO, then R. This is an alkyl. That's the side chain of an ester. Alkyl cyclohexane, what? Carboxylate. So in that case, you can name this carboxamide, okay? Instead of carboxamide, and so on and so forth. Now, I want us to take a typical example. Assuming this compound, the first compound we have here, let's assume we have something of this nature, okay? There is another alkyl group attached here. There is an hydroxy group. Then we have, okay, let's assume this is an ethyl group. How will you name this compound? It's very simple and straightforward. The name of this compound, this must be your carbon one, the carbon that carries the actual functional group. Then you now take care of the position of the substituent. Every other thing attached to the ring are substituent. Because this alkana, carbonyl group of alkana, takes priority over hydroxy group of alcohol. So if you go this direction, this will be 2, 2, 4, plus 3, 7, plus 4, that is 11, plus 5, that will be 12. If we come this way, this will be 2, 3, 5, plus 3, 6, plus 5, 5, that will be 16. So we have to go this direction, 4, 5. So in that case, hydroxy starts with H, ethyl starts with E. So we have 2 ethyl, 4 hydroxy. Hydroxy what? Yeah, the methyl groups. 2 what? 3, 5. 3, 5. Trimethyl, okay, cyclohexane, carbaldehyde, okay. Now, take a look at this. You have something of this nature, COOH. We now have here COH, and here there is an hydroxy group. Here, there are two methyl groups. How will you name this compound? Now, we have three functional groups here. Alkanoic acid, alkanal functional group, and hydroxy functional group of alcohol. Meanwhile, here, this particular functional group is the major functional group of the compound. So in that case, this carbonyl group of alkanal will be named as formyl. Because formaldehyde is the own name of alkanal. So this will be named as formyl, this will be named as hydroxy. Which direction are we going to follow? Automatically it has to be this. Because if we follow here and make this carbon 1, this is 2, 2, 4, plus 4, 8, plus 6, 14. If you go this direction, this will be 2, plus 3, plus 4, that will be 6. 6 plus 6 plus 6, that will give us 18. So meaning this direction, I think it's better, 4, 5, 6. So how do we name this? We have hydroxy, formyl first, 6, formyl, okay? Then 4, hydroxy what? 2, 2, dimethyl cyclohexane, carboxylic acid, or you say cyclohexane methanoic acid. So in that case, this, let's take another example. Another typical example of that. When you have the carbon that carries the functional group not being part of the actual chain of the compound, in the ring. So assuming we have something of this nature, C, 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 O, N, CH3, CH3. Okay, here, if we have chloro, here chloro, CH3, then CH3. Okay, let me change this chloro to something else. It's high time we have something of this nature. Okay, so how do we name this? Of course, this carbon we carry the, that's the functional group, so that must be our carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3. Then on carbon 3, you have a phenyl group, phenyl, P-H-E-N-Y-L, and a cyclohexyl group. Assuming something is attached to the cyclic ring, let's assume we have something of this nature. Alright, how do we name? We have about different substituents, methyl, fluoro, phenyl, cyclohexyl. Cyclohexyl to be named first, followed by fluoro. So in that case, we have three. On the cyclohexyl, 1, 2, 3, we have 2, 3, 3, trimethyl, cyclohexyl, bracket closed. Okay, we now have 3 fluoro. Okay, we have 2, 2 dimethyl. What again? 3 phenyl. Okay, pro. Oh, so in that case, the nitrogen of the amide group has 2 methyl groups. So they are side chains. And when you are naming compounds of that of those kinds, you have to name the side chain alkyl group first. So this is supposed to be N dimethyl. Then you continue with the name of the compound. That is, on the nitrogen of the compound of the functional group, there are 2 methyl groups attached to it. N dimethyl. It is not necessary for you to put a knife in here, because this, what you have here, are side chain naming. Not the substituent are not part of the straight chain. So what we have next? 3 phenyl propanamide. Propanamide. That is the name of the compound. Now, there are some compounds whereby the functional group will be part of the cyclic ring. Typical examples are what we have like this. This is cyclohexanone. When you have something of this nature, this is cyclopentanamine. Because the functional group is part of the ring. Then if you have something of this nature, this is cyclobutadiene. You can also name this cyclopentaneamine. Cyclopentaneamine. So I want us to take a look at some examples on how to name compounds of those kinds. And a typical example is this compound. You have something of this nature. Okay? You have NCH3. CH3 2. Okay? Then here, assuming you have hydroxy group here, then likewise here, assuming you have a methyl group. Okay? So here, you have CH3 CH2. Now, how do we name compounds of this kind? There are different functional groups here, about 3 of them. We have the hydroxy group of alkanol, we have the carbonyl group of ketone, we have the amino group of amine. But out of the 3, the carbonyl group takes precedence over others, meaning others have to be named as substituent. Now, how do we name them? Let's take a look. This carbon must be our carbon 1, being the functional group. And going clockwise will give us the least position of the substituent. So we have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In alphabetical order, amino should be named first. Now, in naming the amino, on the nitrogen of the amino, there are 2 sets of alkyl groups. Let us spread this, let us extend these bonds instead of writing it in condensed structure. So we have CH3, then on this, there is another CH3 here. Okay, that is what we have. So this isopropyl, or the one you call 1-methyl-ethyl. Why this one is an ethyl group? So on carbon 2, we have 2, N, okay, N isopropyl, N methyl amino. I hope this is clear. On the amino group, you have this, you have this, so you have to name them. Amino, then hydroxyne, no, ethyl, 5-ethyl. After ethyl, what we have? 3-hydroxy. Okay, after that, then we have methyl group. 3-methyl cyclohexanone. Cyclohexanone. So this is typical ways of naming cyclic organic compounds. Now, in that case, we can move on to another thing, and that is how do we name aromatic organic compounds? The simplest member of aromatic organic compounds is benzene. And we are going to focus our attention here on monoaromatic organic compounds. Because organic compounds can be classified into three. We have the mono, those ones containing one benzene ring. We have the di, those ones with two benzene rings. Typical example is naphthalene. We have the polyaromatics, those containing three or more benzene rings, like anthracene, among others. Now, the monos of said benzene, we have them in large number, but typical examples are this. This is what we call phenol. When you have hydroxy group attached to the benzene, when you have amino group attached to it, we call it anilene, or simply aminobenzene. You can as well name it as phenylalanine. Phenylalanine. Okay. Another example is you have something like this, CHO, and that is benzaldehyde. Benzaldehyde. Okay, when you have something like this, COOH, this is benzoic acid. Okay, when you have it in this format, on the benzene ring, you have SO3H. This is benzene sulfonic acid. When you have something of this nature attached to the benzene, OOR. This is alkyl benzoate. That's an ester. Okay? When you have an alkyl group attached to the benzene, we call this alkyl benzene. If this is methyl group, it becomes methyl benzene or simply toluene. Okay? You can as well have something like this on the benzene. C double bond O NH2. This is benzamide. Benzamide. Okay? Likewise, on the benzene ring, if you have a group of this kind, where X is an halogen, we have this as benzoyl halide. So, any substituent that is attached to any of these make the compound di-substituted or poly-substituted aromatic organic compound or benzene. Let's take an example. But before we go into how to name di-substituted or poly-substituted benzene, we have to consider that in benzene, there are three important positions. And if you use those positions to name the substituents, it is allowed instead of using the numbering system. What are these substituents? They are the auto, meta, and the para positions. When you have something like this, a disubstituted benzene, this is X, Y. When you have another disubstituted benzene of this kind, X, Y. And we can as well have something like this, X, Y. Okay, in this, this is carbon 1, assuming X is the main functional group. Y, this is carbon 2. So 1, 2, disubstituted benzene are also referred to as ortho. That is the ortho position. But not only 1, 2. Okay, I'm coming to that. Don't forget that if this is 1, 2, if you come this direction and your Y is attached to this carbon instead of this direction, it will still be 1, 2. But from this direction, this is carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means positions 2 and 6 are the same to this X, which is the main functional group. So 1 and 2, as well as 1 and 6, are the ortho positions. And they can simply be written as letter O, ortho, whatever. Now, likewise here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If this Y comes to this carbon 5 and it is not attached here, then we have to come this direction. Meaning this carbon position and this carbon position on the ring are the same, just as 1 and 2. So in that case, 1, 3 and 1, 5 are equal. And that is what we have as meta substituted, simply letter M. Now, any substituent that is attached to the benzene ring parallel to the main functional group, that particular position, 1, 2, 3, 4, is called carbon 1 and 4 are the para position. And that is simply written as letter T. Now, with this, we can take an example on how to name some disubstituted organic compound. Okay? Now, do not forget that whether you use the numbering system or you use the auto meta para system, the name will of course be the same, but you have to get yourself familiar with both in case you have a compound written in a particular form. That will not be strange to you. Take a look at this compound. Okay, this is a benzene. Here, assuming we have something like this, O, CH2, CH3. Okay, assuming here we have a nitro group. Here we have a chloro group. Here there is an ethyl group attached to this. Then there is a methyl group attached here. Then let us assume there is an hydroxy group. So looking at this compound, the main functional group here is this, which contains the carbonyl group. Carbonyl group of what? Alkanoate. Because there is an oxygen and an alkoxy group, ethoxy to be precise, attached to the carbonyl group. That makes it an ester. So this carbon that carries the functional group must be our carbon 1. Automatically, that's carbon 1. Now, which direction are we going to follow? Whichever direction, the positions of the substituent when you have the numbers together will be equal. Because all the carbon atoms in the ring, in the benzene ring, are substituted. So in that case, we have to consider the direction that will give us the least position of the substituent to be named first. And that is a chloro group. Yes, the first constituent is chloro. And if you follow this direction, chloro is on carbon 3. If you follow here, it will be on carbon 5. So meaning, we have to go this way. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the name of the compound is 3-chloro. Okay? Then followed by ethyl. 2-ethyl. Okay? Then methyl or hydroxy. 6 hydroxy, then methyl or nitro, 5 methyl, 4 nitro. Nitro what? Oh, we have forgotten to name the side chain. When you are naming an ester, the side chain needs to be named first, just as in alkanamide as well as amine. So we have to name this side chain on the functional group, which is ethyl. Don't forget this, that's supposed to come first. Ethyl, then whatever you have in the ring, and then the functional group. 4-nitro-benzoate. Now, I told you that the 3 position, the carbon 3 of the benzene is a meta position, so you can name this as meta-ethyl-meta-chloro. Carbon 2, auto-ethyl. Carbon 6, auto-hydroxy. Carbon 5, meta-methyl. Carbon 4, para-nitro. That is also accepted as the name of the compound. So in our next episode or series, We are going to look at how to name bicyclic organic compounds as well as pyro organic compounds. I believe you have learned one or two things today. In case you have questions or compounds unable to name, you can quickly send me a message on my YouTube account, or send text message or WhatsApp message on my MTN displayed on the screen. Thank you for listening. Hope to see you again. You are welcome.